Yo, what is up? We're also supposed to make a play. skystormerX here, showing you guys a brand new set and Necromancer. So as always, this is on the Minewind server, so if you feel like a boss, come play with me there. Yo, what's going on guys? skystormerX here, and welcome back to another wonderful video on this channel. So today we're going to be going through the Necromancer set as well as the Antimage chestplate. So if you enjoy this type of content, leave a like down below, leave a comment telling me you want more of it, and let's not waste time, let's just get to reviewing the set. All of the items I'm showing in today's video you can get from the giant keys, which come from the giant event, which is being shown on screen right now. Basically, you kill the skeletons, ignore the giants, and you get keys from it. Pretty epic. Pretty great event, I'd rate it 8 of 8, but this chestplate, however, I'd rate 9 out of 8, because it is a Blast Protection 5, Protection 6, Unbreaking 10 golden chestplate that greatly reduces incoming magic damage, increases your health pool by 100%, and is ultra durable. All around, I'm glad that this chestplate exists now because we've needed it for ever since Rift Fireball meta, to be honest. Just, it counters Ice Shinto, it counters Rift Fireball, as I said. It's a great chestplate. That being said, chestplate's pretty simple. Let's get into some of the more complicated items. So the next item that we have are the Necromancer boots, which are Forever Falling 9, Protection 6, Soul Speed 1, Unbreaking 10, Never 8 boots that suck absorption hearts from sacred blocks, and increase your health pool by 40%. They also accumulate one undead soul. One more thing that's kind of interesting about these are the way that they spell Satan. I don't think it's supposed to be spelled with an I, I'm not gonna lie. So these might become rare, so I'd keep them if you have them. So the next item we have here are the Necromancer leggings, which are Protection 6, Unbreaking 10, Neverite legs, which suck regeneration from sacred blocks, increase health pool by 30%, and accumulate one undead soul. The leggings themselves aren't anything too special, but they do have a really good interaction with the Bone Path spellbook, which we'll get into later. The next item we have on the list is the Necromancer's Chestplate, which is a Protection 7, Unbreaking 10, Neverite Chestplate that sucks strength from sacred blocks, increases your health pool by 30%, and accumulates one undead soul. This is similar to a Byron Hilt, except for it holds an undead soul and is slightly worse, but still a pretty good chestplate, exclusively for the soul. The Necromancer's Mask is actually unenchanted, which is kind of uncalled for a Minewind item, to be honest. But it is pretty good because it is unbreakable, being Liver Skeleton Skull. It gives you permanent night vision and increases your health pool by 40%. It also accumulates one undead soul. With the Necromancer's Mask not having protection, it means that if you are wearing a full Necromancer set, you will only be Protection 19, with 20 being the maximum. But still, you're not going to be as protected as any other set. The first spellbook is the Cursed Skull spellbook, which, apart from looking pretty cool, exploding into a soul sand mess and shooting out a Wither Skeleton Skull, is absolutely useless. It does no damage. Yeah, it just hit me. That did, like, no damage. Like, for real.
Yeah, it doesn't do damage.
Keep in mind, I was gappled for that, but also you have the chance of it hitting you with Wither, like, right here. Just all around, don't use this unless you want to be flashy or just use it for fun. So the next spellbook we have is the Escape Skeleton spellbook, which just basically teleports you to a random area somewhere around where you were. This could be in any direction, and puts a decoy in your place. It's wearing what you were wearing and holding what you were holding. This spellbook is best used offhand so you can maximize the amount of damage the skeleton decoy will do. But it's not really that competitively viable unless you're trying to get away anyway. So you're not using the spellbook for damage, but it's still nice to have it do damage. The Bone Path spellbook is hard to describe because it's a spellbook that does a lot. So, first effect, it places bones under where you walk and will infinitely dig you down. Be careful, it'll even dig you through bedrock if you walk on it enough. I've actually tried this. So look out for that. But the way that you get back up from this bone hole is that you jump, and it'll give you levitation for a little bit. So as you can see around me right now, I am stepping on bone, which counts as a sacred block. So that means that the Necromancer set activates and sucks absorption, regeneration, and strength from these blocks. Which means that as long as you're standing on these blocks, you're going to have these effects. It's actually a really overpowered strategy to use the bone path to jump up, get away from your opponent, because when you're up in the air like this, unless they use something like a shoot web or an ice trap, you've gotten away. Bone path does not work on slabs, and it also does not work on chests, but that does not mean that you should start running around in your base with this spellbook on. It's not a fun cleanup process, believe me. So next up we have the army builders, which are the Skeleton Scout and Skeleton Master. Now the Master has a Torquem, never right, and a Backstabber in his offhand. So he does damage and binds your opponents if he hits them. The Skeleton Scout shoots explosive arrows and jumps around like a guy on crack. So these mobs do despawn, but they don't despawn very often, or at least the conditions are really hard to meet to make them despawn. So it's really easy to get at least 50 skeletons down at a time to wreak havoc on spawn, as I'm about to do. The Skeleton Masters are best when you're actually trying to PvP your opponent, like an actual human being. But when you're just trying to mess around and wreak as much havoc as possible, use the Skeleton Scouts all around. So now that I have built a sizable army, let's test it on the tool auction here. Yep, I'd say that's pretty good. Now let's try it on Patrick Star.
But I'd been forgotten, I Joe. I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? But I'd been forgotten, I Joe. I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go?
The only way you can have a chance of escaping that army once they get on you is to log off. So yeah, I'm gonna end the video here, guys. I hope you enjoyed. I gotta go to work now. And I gotta do my taxes, gosh darn it. Okay. Well, anyway. I hope you have a wonderful day, and later.